let's create the top of a mountain, not just a standalone mountain, but actually something really tall and rugged, and you can see like the top part of it. Let me show you what I mean. So I'm going to create a mountain node, and then I'm going to set it to strata mode so I can get some of these cool uplifts on the top of the mountain. Which, fun fact, this is how most mountains are made, especially the big tall ones. So they uplift like this. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase the height and I'm going to increase the scale. But then at the same time, I'm going to reduce the bulk. So what happens is we get these amazing pinnacles, like these cool looking sharp mountains. But I want to adjust this a little bit. So I'm going to increase the scale even more. So it's really high. And I'm going to see if I can maybe reduce the height a little bit and then also try a different seed. If it's not, you know, better than this, we can always come back. It's easy to remember. It's 6,000. So rare to get a round number. So now you can see we have all these cool different shapes. Ooh, I like this one. Let's stick with this one for now. So the next step is I want to actually smooth out some of these really sharper, taller peaks. So I am going to create thermal erosion dew. It's going to help me shave off some of this stuff. So let's increase the duration. You can see it's also creating this beautiful talus out here on everything. Next step, we add erosion. So I'll add erosion dew. Increase the duration. I'm going to also increase the erosion scale just because I want to have larger flow networks being generated here. And then I'll increase the coarse sediments all the way. So it's creating all these beautiful flows. And then I'll increase the coarse angle just a little bit so that we can have more of this sediment high up on these slopes. Now I'm going to create one more erosion pass, and this time I'm going to have, again, the sediments, but then have them be very low. And let me increase the erosion scale and duration so we get more of this. And so, let me see, I probably reduced the downcutting just a little bit. So now with these two passes, we have this whole mountain. I think one of the things that happened was we lost a little bit of the peaks that we had up here. So to prevent that from happening, I'll cheat a little bit. And I'm going to turn on mask by height and mask out all this area. I'm going to increase the fall off. So it's a gentle effect and a little bit of distortion. Then come back down here like so. And then here in this one, instead of masking it, I'm just going to reduce the erosion duration a little bit and play with the shape so I can maybe retain some of the original. Although I like the high sharpness, but okay, this will do. So that's now a cool complex mountainscape. To add even more detail to it, what I'll do is I'll add a level of outcrops. So you can see it's starting to create all this rocky detail. But I'm going to reduce the height of this rocky detail. Like so. And then I'll run another erosion pass on top of this. This time, again, we'll have lots of coarse sediments. Let's increase the bed load as well. I'm going to reduce the down cutting and increase the duration. So it does this. And then I will switch to min mode. So then we get all this beautiful exposed strata right there. This is looking cool. So now I am going to create an adjust node and artificially increase the height like so. Normally, I wouldn't do that for terrains, but just because we're dealing with a mountain peak and we lost a little bit of the original peak down here or up here, I want to bring some of it back. It was artificially high because when we started, we had low bulk. Now, again, if I switch to medium bulk, you can see we get something like this. And going through the rest of the process, we would end up with something like this. So we don't have that beak at all. So I'm going to go back, switch to low, go through the erosion and outcrops, and then erosion again, and then artificially raise this. So that's our mountain. And now that it's artificially raised, let's add one more pass of erosion. So in this, because we have the stronger slopes because of the added height, the erosion process has new angles literally to play with. So when we have bed load or suspended load or coarse sediments, any of these, they have a lot more slope to play with. And so we're now getting all this beautiful detail. If you don't want it to be so detailed, you can reduce the detail size, because then you want to have more focus on the flows, for example. I'm going to reduce downcutting just a tad and increase duration so that we get, again, these bigger flows. We can adjust the coarse angle to bring the flow further down here than up here, or inversely bring it way more up the slope to give it that bulkier feeling. Personally, though, I like it a little bit down here. There's something interesting going on. So this is now turning into a cool mountain peak. And I'm tempted to add a bit more, just a little bit more. So I'm going to add sandstone, which is not generally what we would think of on a landscape like this. But I'm going to go here. I'm going to turn off chipped. And what I want to do is create all these beautiful striations, because you do find them a lot on these tall mountains. So I'm going to increase the spacing between these strata, and I'm going to set the passes to 4 so that it repeats it many times. Okay, that's way too many. I'm going to switch down to 2, and I'm going to reduce the intensity a bit. And finally, lots of chaos. Always a lot of chaos, like so. But since we don't want this dominating the whole mountain, I'm going to mask this by height, bring it down here a little. High fall off, lots of distortion, so there's some unevenness. Now I think I will bring up the intensity a little bit, just so the effect plays better. I can now reduce the actual height since we have a very high fall off. So something like this, maybe change the convexity of it. And then I'll have one more passive erosion. Again, high sedimentation, like so. But then I will also go back to min mode so that some of this exposed strata can creep through, like out here. So I think this is really good and ready. Last thing we need to do is texture this. And so rather than setting up a whole texture-based system and whatnot, I'm going to be lazy. I'm just going to have a single sat map directly hooked up to erosion. And now I'm just going to spend a little bit of time trying to find the right sat map that will work on this, because I would like to have variation in the colors based on the different levels of altitude. So something like this, for example, or if we were to reverse it, like so. Let's try it. We can always change this. And so I'll go straight to color erosion after this, feed it the erosion, the last erosion as the height, and then really just amp up all the settings. Well, not all the settings, but most of the settings. And so you can see that's already giving us this beautiful texture. But I think these colors may be just a tad too stark. So another thing we can do is let's mix and match. I'm going to add one more sat map. And let's, so this one was 189. Ah, funny, this is also 189. But let's go for a different tone. Like maybe this one or this one. Or let's go for this one. But instead of having it be just plain strata lines like this, I'm going to have medium roughness, which will just jitter the shapes around a little bit and then create noise. I'm going to combine these two, and then I'm going to feed that to the color erosion. And there you can see we're kind of now getting a better palette. It's not so stark like this, and it's like this. We can also play around a bit with blend modes. I'm not sure what exactly we will get, but if we switch to min, we get more of the previous one dominating, because of course that's a darker shade. If we go max, then it's the other way around. And then we have blend. But what I liked in max is we get to keep some of the stronger, brighter peaks as compared to blend, where they become dull. So let's go with max for now. And it's only 50%. We could probably make it higher, but nah, 50% is fine. And then when we feed this to our color erosion, you can see we get this beautiful map. I think my flow volume is a bit high, so I'm going to reduce that a little bit. And now if we go here, or you know what, in fact, let me switch this to 4K so we can see this in great detail. And there now we have our terrain in really high definition. So you can see we have all these beautiful shapes up here. There's all the flows coming down. We have that stratification that we added and all kinds of beautiful mountain structures up here. So there you have it. That's a tall mountain range that we can play with further. You can easily add snow, like just go here, add snow, and we'll have lots of beautiful snow. You can play with melt and just create some cool shapes on this snowy mountain, play with however you like. And so yeah, this is a great way to get like a mountain that you might want to use as a background asset, maybe in a skybox, maybe in a VFX shot. You can easily create multiple different variations. So for example, if I switch back to 1K, just so it processes a bit faster, and I go back to our original mountain, and so instead of this seed, I'm going to randomly select something else, like this, where, oh, we have split peaks. And then using this same process, just go back all the way to the end. And you can see how well this works. We have that same setting, just a whole different landscape. So you can play with this, create multiple variations, assets, however you want to play with them, and then set them up in your scene.